Welcome to my channel.
In between food. There is never a good time to snack. Feel like it? Do it. The unplanned nature of this meal has always made it fun, not to mention the liberties it allows you with food. Think pakoras on a rainy day or ramen on a cold winter evening. Not the healthiest food for sure, one of the reasons why it is also not the most preferred meal of the day. Weight woes, high sodium levels. Blame it on the munchies. The inherently chewy nature of this meal has earned it, mostly, brickbats. But with kale and sweet potato fries, savoury desserts, nuts and seed mixes and grab-and-go yogurts, the snacking scene has had an overhaul. It is now a convenient, healthy and innovative meal of the day. Snack that. According to market research firm Mintel, millennials are snacking away and how. They are more likely than any other generation to snack 4 times a day or, in many cases, more than that. For them, snacking is the dominant meal of their day and not an elaborate lunch or dinner. Moreover, with a desire for clean, organic, less processed, GMO-free, antibiotic-free, additive-free and locally sourced products, they are revolutionizing appetizers. Also, this generation prefers a shorter dining experience and quick eating options. Their passion for plant-based protein as an alternative to meat is in full bloom. The result is a wide variety of snacks based on peas, lentils, nuts, beans and chickpeas. Dinosh or not? The eat every 2 hours theory is gospel truth today. People who eat more than 3 times a day tend to weigh less, according to University of Massachusetts Medical School research. But, while nibbling does help in more weight loss as per research, there is a science to that as well. Snacking is healthy as long as it's not too frequent. The digestive system needs a break to digest the previous meal and not work constantly to digest food. Your digestive system uses about 75 to 80% of the body's total energy, and that's a lot. Some of this energy needs to go to your daily routine, movement and the upkeep of the functioning of the heart and lungs as well. Constant digesting will have a negative impact on your immunity system and healing process. The idea is healthy snacking at the right time and interval, says Cotton O. Watch or munch. In the end, one should watch the overall calorie intake during the whole day, for optimal health, says Kamal. So be a wise snacker. First, limit the amount of snack, the snack quantity should not be more than a fistful. Secondly, snack healthy, she adds. According to Cotton O, nuts, seeds, macchanas, homemade popcorns are the best options. Microwaved popcorns are not good, they should be cooked in the old vessels, and nuts should be unsalted. He says, snacks like succable are great options if you minus all the junk and deep fried stuff you add to it. Instead make it with sprouts and tomatoes. Instead of choosing the conventional snack like pakora, samosa, bhujia, go for nutritious options like fruits, nuts, poa and boiled, roasted chana. Snacking on a seasonal fruit can never be a bad option.